Hey guys, welcome back to Therapeutic Thursday. Today's Therapeutic Thursday, I'm a little scared for it. I know that everybody and their brother has seen this, so I thought that I would do a video on it to give you guys a little bit more information. The dreaded black peel-off mask. I've used this once, and please let me tell you, it works. It hurts. It hurts. I read that if you put a thicker layer on, it doesn't hurt as bad. Bull crapo. It hurt. So, today I'm going to tell you a little bit about it. We're going to apply it. You're going to watch me cry as I peel it off. And then we'll see what it brings out of my skin. So, if you're interested in this black mask, then you've come to the right place. Keep on watching. Alright, so first I'm going to read the back of it to you. And then we'll get to applying. It tells the ingredients, but it says to dry the cleansed area and apply the mask on desired area. Avoid your eyebrow, your eyes, and your lips. Please listen to that. Peel it off after 20 to 30 minutes. To achieve better results, apply toner so as to tighten and cleanse the pores thoroughly. Now, the front of it, this is from the brand Shields Natural Science. Deep Cleansing Black Mask smooths the skin's texture. Purifying peel-off mask increases vitality. Deep Cleansing Peel-Off Mask removes dulling surface cells and impurities, while vitamins and plant extracts soften the skin to restore a youthful glow. Honey, yes, it removes dulling surface cells. It removes, like, your blood vessels from inside of your face. It is painful, and I swore I would never do it again, but just for a video for my YouTube channel, show you guys how this works, I'm going to. That better let y'all know that I love you. I love all y'all. Because I swore I would never do this again. Oh, it hurts so bad. Alright, so I cleaned my face. I've got it washed. It's nice and clean. And I'm just going to use, this is a Clinique foundation brush. It's like the flat paddle kind of brush. I find these work best to apply masks to your face. So what I do is I just squirt some out on the brush like that. And then I just start swapping this onto my face. Avoid the eyebrow area. Now, don't forget. The thing that makes this mask hurt so bad is because it pulls all your facial hair, like your peach fuzz and stuff. And it hurts so blessed bad. So I'm hoping that this time it won't hurt as bad because I shaved my face yesterday. I don't know if any of you guys have ever done that, but that's something new that's going around the beauty world. I've been wanting to try it, but I'm scared to death to try it. And I watched some videos the other night of it. And then my friend Christy messaged me yesterday. I kind of took that as a sign because right after I watched the videos, she messages me and tells me that she shaved her face and wanted to know if I had ever done it. And of course not, but of course I did. And so my face is smooth as a baby's butt, so I'm hoping it won't hurt as bad to remove this mask today since I don't have any facial hair left. I'm hoping. I'm praying. Because let me tell you, it hurts like the dickens when you pull this sucker off. When it grabs any hair. Especially like right in here. Oh my God. And right in this area where, oh, I mean, like, it brings tears to your eyes. It hurts so bad. But it works. The first time I used this mask, oh my God. What it pulled out of my face was unreal. Now, I don't know if it'll do as good of a job this time because I have already done it once. And I have been taking very good care of my face, my skin. So I don't know if it'll pull out a bunch of nastiness like it did the first time. You know, that was 34 years of gunk in my face. And it's only been a couple months since I used it. A month maybe, I don't remember how long it's been. But, so I don't know if it will necessarily pull out a bunch of gunk again. But we're going to try. this mask applied. It says to wait 20 to 30 minutes. What I do is I'm just going to wait until it completely dries. It could take a little while depending on how thick of a layer you put on your face. I think the first time I put it on super duper thick and it took about 45 minutes for it to dry down. So in the meantime, I'm going to go clean my brush and, you know, do some laundry or whatever. And as soon as this dries down, I'll be right back and we will remove this together. Woo. Please pray that it doesn't hurt. Alright guys, so it's been about 45 minutes again, just like last time. It takes a while for it to dry. And it is, my face is super tight, like. Oh, I can just feel it cracking when I do that, watch. Look, it's starting to come loose. Look at that. Cool, it didn't do that the first time. Maybe where I shaved my face, it don't really have nothing to hang on to. Ooh. Oh, yeah. I think I'm going to like this. Okay, so here we go. We're going to peel it off. And the way you're supposed to peel it, I'm just going to try to get all the edges loose right quick. You're supposed to peel from the bottom and peel upwards. Oh, God, there's still some hair up here. It's got hair in it. All right, so I'm just going to start down here and just start peeling. Oh, yeah, it don't hurt nothing like it did the first time. Yeah, shave your face before you do this. Oh, yeah, it still hurts a little bit. It's because this skin right here is so sensitive and tender. Oh, God, it hurts right in this area. I think I got it too close to my eyes. Ugh. It don't hurt like it is the first time, but it still hurts. Oh, thank God. Okay, see how it leaves this black thing out here? You just have to wash that off. Alright, so now, let's see. I don't really see nothing. The nose. There's a little bit right there on my nose. I don't know if I'll be able to get this to focus or not, but let's try. Honestly, there's just not a whole lot that it's pulled out. I mean, right here. Let me see if I can take a picture with my phone, and if so, I will insert it right here. Okay, yeah, I did get a couple good pictures where it shows what it pulled off of my nose. It didn't really pull nothing out of the rest of my face, thank God, which shows me that I'm doing a really good job of cleansing my face. So, it's not something that I would want to use, you know, often because of the pain that comes with it, but it does pull the stuff out of your face. So, I mean, it is a good mask. It just, I don't know, they say beauty is pain, so I guess this is an example of it, because it does clean out my pores. I mean, it does pull that gunk and stuff that I'm obviously not getting out when I'm cleaning, and I do a very, very thorough face cleaning every morning and every night, so it does look a lot better this time than it did the first time. If I can find the pictures of the first time, I'll insert them here. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you've been wanting to try this mask out, I mean, you can get online and order it. It is not very costly and it does work. I would love to do it on somebody who has very enlarged pores with a lot of blackheads. I've never had that, so I don't know how well it would work on that skin type. I would love to try it on somebody though, just to see if it will honestly pull all that out of there. So if you do order it and you have that type of skin, make sure you let me know if it pulls that out and if you have already tried it and it did or it didn't. Make sure to let me know down in the comments. But anyway, that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget about the giveaways going on. I'm almost to 500. When we hit 500, one of you are going to win a $30 gift card to Ulta or Sephora. And on May 30th, the other giveaway ends with the bundle of some of my favorite beauty products. So make sure you look down in the description bar and check out the rules for entering that giveaway. And I love you guys. I'll see you tomorrow for Friday Free Day. Bye.